I miss you, Bat Buddies. And I'm going to take a little bit of time today to talk to you. A little bit of time away from this monotonous reconstruction, renovation stuff that I always do in my spare time with every house I ever live in. And talk to you guys a little bit about this great thing that Alfred left me in my cave. So let's do an unboxing.
Hey, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, RC1. And I've got a thing sitting on my desk over here. Let's go see what that is. Not Rad Dad. Sometimes I don't feel like a Rad Dad anymore. Kids have gone off. What's that say? Catwoman, Julie Newmar. Wow. Hey guys, what do you think? Should we see what this is? I mean, you look kind of lonely in the cave, you know? No girls around. You know, when I used to watch these guys.
Ah, the glory days of nursery school and kindergarten.
My first crush. You know, it's memory serves. It was either Batgirl or Catwoman. Probably Catwoman. She was more mysterious. Batgirl was good, you know. Good's fun, too. But Catwoman, I don't know. Anyway, Alfred has gone. I've spent the last couple of weeks with Alfred. Come on over here. He's back on the road today, back to Nashville. I've spent a couple of weeks with him in and out of my life here. He's been in a cave a few times. We even did a video, but it was on the Grail Diary, so I don't know if you guys were that interested in that. He left me this nice little bat cycle, which I'll put up here by this Batmobile that Jay did a trade with me for. Pretty cool. I'm not going to open it. I'm not a collector. I told him, hey, anything you have, I'll display it, I'll have it, I'll keep it, I'll put it somewhere in the cave, but I don't collect. So he didn't want to do anything with this, and he knew that I was a Julie Newmar fan. Well, obviously, like I said, my first crush, I was riding a big wheel. You notice something about somebody like this. They're not like your mother. They're a special kind of girl. They're not like the girls that are young, that are in kindergarten or nursery school or whatever. They're special. And this one wore a glittery suit. Anyway, we're going to do an unboxing here because Alfred left me this. And I guess he didn't want it. He's got too many things. He realizes he'll go through his life and he'll never be able to do all the things that he's currently got, let alone new projects. He's always got ideas and new projects for me. And I say, Alfred, you just don't understand. I don't have the time for what you want to do. It's great that you're exercising your mind and you're giving me all these ideas, but I can't do it. I tell the Bat Buddies this all the time. We were walking around Apex the other day. That's one of the places where they built the Back to the Future car for the parts there. And he said, why don't you get this and this and this and go in here and show the guys how you can do that utility belt, the ultimate utility belt of all these things and everything. I said, no, you don't understand. They're not interested enough. Even if I was successful, they wouldn't care. I watched a video the other day. 235,000 hits. A guy who put together the ultimate display of the Dark Knight. And I said, geez, how come he can get 230,000 and the most I ever get is 1,000? Unless I'm showing how to sculpt something. I got like 20,000 or more on those like a decade ago. And I looked and said, oh, it's because every single video he does is this. Every single video is about a costuming display or a new thing or whatever. He's got all these subscribers and all these subscribers go and watch any video he does. So when he finally gets to the Batman display, they're all watching that one. I'm like a guy that only does this. I'm so caught up in it since childhood. I can't help it. It's like Bryn used to say, my brother has a bat. You don't choose the bat chooses you. And that's the way it's been. I needed that in my life. I had a reticent, shy kind of father. Golly gee, did I ever practice it? I look towards other things for my worldly wisdom. I look towards television and movies and the artistic visual expressions of fantasy, but also ideas. When I named my first company Televisionaries, it's because I was moved by that, not books, but by what artists do in other ways. You know, even Mr. Rogers. You know, I was moved by what he did, trying to talk to people and try to relate to people. You know, you can tell I do those things. So anyway, this is not something I would ever go after, but since it's here, gosh, this is heavy. Oh, shoot, that's really well crafted. Holy mackerel, that's well crafted. I thought I was going to have to paint it. It's already painted? Yeesh. This is a high quality statue. This is really nice. I can just tell by looking at it. But that is really, no wonder it's padded so well. That is really high quality. I think it's, she's got a body stocking on. It's not even painted. Wow, isn't that something? How did they get that on there? It's loose right down to the gloves. Oh my gosh, that's really something. He had to leave. He couldn't stay any longer. He's going to the Louisville Model Show. He did his biggest highlight of the year. And I can see why he's enthralled by these things. I can't get enthralled by anything unless it's full size. So even though this is wonderful, the first thing I say is I know she was skinnier than that. But this artist had a great understanding of form. And the detailing. If you could make this actual thing like this, even these boots, people would want them. But it's so much easier to work small like this, cost-wise. Boy, I'm gonna have to be really careful. I set this down and go look at the rest of the stuff here. Oh, okay. Well, all it is that he mentioned the only thing that was wrong with it is the mask has cracked or broken. Okay. And I would have to fabricate it. You know, I love the mask, and it'd be nice to be able to put it on and take it back off. But I also love her unique face. There's nobody like her ever in the world. So what a great girl to have one of your first crushes on. There's never been a girl like that. There will never be another girl like that. She's unique. So, you know, I'm not going to argue it. So this whole model's done, apparently. The whole model's done. There's nothing to do. It's just the mask, just like you said. I hear I was envisioning I was going to have to paint this whole thing and do the whole thing, but it's all done except for the mask. Oh, it's even got a little loose belt. Did you put the little belt on there? Wow. Okay. Well, Alfred, thanks. This is something that we'll see whether there's any interest in this. He always says, why don't you do this? Why don't you do that? And the Bat Buddies will really appreciate that. Oh, that little ball of yarn. I say, because I've been doing this for 30 years, and I kind of know what they're going to like and what they're not. And it doesn't matter anyway, because I don't get paid for any of it. It's only for my fun. And I say, like, right now, I could be doing construction, like I showed you in the beginning of the video. That's what I'm doing right now. And that's why you haven't seen me too much. But instead, I'm spending a little time in here. Why? Because I'm waiting for a cape to finish up and some latex to process. And it's not quite light out. I got up at like 5 o'clock. I usually get up around 5 o'clock. Yeah. You get more done in the early morning hours, I find. So I really, really treasure. I'm kind of on Florida time. I never switched to California time. I go to bed early, you know? It's like I'm still living on the East Coast. All right, so I didn't see any signs of a mask in here. Before I throw any of this padding out, I'll have to look and see if there is any other kind of a mask in here. But the first thing I'll do is I'll go ahead and set this in the obvious place it's supposed to go. So this is what a really well-crafted model is. You know, if he didn't give me this, I would never know because I don't go to the model show. I wanted to go with him one time, but when I started thinking about it, and I thought to myself, gosh, I got hotels, I got all these other things. I thought, I can't really afford that. I got some Bat Buddies that want to meet up at Dragon Con right now. How's that going there? Well, not perfect, okay. And I said, well, I want Alfred to come. I'll join you if he'll come. And then I call him back and I say, he's not coming. Oh, I see, it goes in that little tiny hole there. Okay, there we go. Oh, and then it goes down. Wow. That's just impressively built. Oh my gosh, the love and adoration of this artist for this person has to top my own if it's possible. Okay, here we go. We've got a little piece of hair coming off and a little thing that goes, I guess, through the belt on the other side or whatever. I'll have to figure that out. So I'll just set this off to the side. And there's just a little piece of hair coming off. Where's that little? Over on the edge there. Okay. So what I would really like to do, gosh, what I would really like to do is take that piece off of there and make it somehow so you can connect the the mask, but not have to have it on there. Because then you can't really see her for what she is. And I appreciate her for what she is. So that's going to be my project should I choose to accept it. So this is just going to be remaining an unboxing. And obviously, I'm not going to be able to perform this in the speedy way that I normally would do a video for you guys. This is going to take care, worthy of care and thought. So I'm going to just finish this up and go back to my construction. And I'm not going to do another belt for you guys. I've done plenty of belts. I don't know what I'm going to do on this channel. But Jaden from the Cowl Vault, he said, I'm waiting for your next video. I got inspired on the last one. I did a project. I'm glad to hear that. A lot of people say they appreciate some of these crazy things I do with the belts and the different things on this channel. And some of the things might be practical for working with the actual pieces that you might have. Some might not be. But I run this channel according to me. This is Mr. Robert's neighborhood. So it's according to the way I am interested in things and see things. And this one fits the bill. I am interested. Yes, I am. As well as I am in this. Shoot. I looked through the whole cave and I realized behind here, I can't really access it right now. Are my pictures of Yvonne Craig. Can't show you, but you've seen them. But I've seen Julie Newmar. Wow, they even got the zipper. Well, of course they have to because it's a bodysuit. I've seen Julie Newmar in real life a number of times, and I gotta say, she's a freak of nature. I mean, just like any great genius has a little touch of the insane. If I'm a genius, I definitely have that, right? She is just, it's almost like somebody took a hammer to the toe of smashed part of the foot of Michelangelo's Statue of David in Florence, Italy. I was there and I saw it in person before it was destroyed. And even he made the head a different size because he knew the way it was going to be looked at. This girl is large and she's freaky. And freakier as she gets older, maybe, because her fullness and everything has changed. But it took that to be this incredible person that she is. Anybody could probably get that bod, you know? And anybody could probably learn some of the mannerisms and dress really cool and look really sexy and whatnot. But she did it first. And she did it her own way. And I appreciate that as a guy riding his big wheel.
I wish I had a picture of that. This one's just a little bit earlier. Always costuming some way.
And even today, you know, on my page, it says, when I was a child, I thought as a child. When I became a man, I put away childish things. I forget what it says. I haven't looked there so long. I haven't updated my website in 10 years. This is where you come if you want to know what's going on with me. You ask questions, you comment. But the truth is, anything that has that kind of longevity, I'll tell you, they're not making people like us anymore. They're not making the old world types any longer. People are getting soft. Everybody thinks, oh, I press a button or I do the thumb thing or whatever, or I make something look good. How many people are actually making things? I really just put my respect and just value out there to anybody of you that wants to make things, even if they're out of junk like I show you, or something that takes sculpture skills and lots of time to perfect and work through. Even if you work on a computer printout, I mean, you have to work the model, right? You have to know what looks good versus not. You have to persevere and try many test runs and things like that. And all you people that work with foam and paper and just whatever you have, good for you. And all you people with PVC, newspaper, and duct tape mannequins. I don't know if you do that anymore, but you used to. I appreciate it. Okay, so this is going to be a labor of love. I'm going to have to work on this, get a chip out of the ear, the hair's falling off, the belt, I don't know how it works, and that mask is not even there. Obviously, I can create it. I don't have time for this. I've got to get back and renovate the house. But I spent a little time with you today, Bat Buddies. And I thank you for joining me on this quiet early morning in my cave. With Alfred not here, after a couple of weeks of being here, I'm going to be on my own for a while. And I'm going to be lonely. And I'm going to wish I could be in here talking to you guys. But I got to think of things that I haven't done. Think of things that you'd be interested in. That I can do easily. In addition to everything else I do. And that's hard. But thanks for tuning in and letting me talk to you. And now I'd like to hear you say a few things back, if you would, in the comments. Appreciate it. Talk to you later, Bat Buddies. I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One.
I forgot to say in the video, he came out here to trade a car for some of this stuff. A car.